just knew in your heart that God was speaking to you, like there was just something that really tugged at you, that really just spoke to you, something you couldn't shake, a feeling you just could not get rid of. And you knew God was telling you, this is what I need to do. This is where I need to go. This is the place that I need to be. But somehow fear creeps in. Somehow just not knowing what to expect, what things are going to be like. It gets the best of you sometimes, and you run away from the very thing that you know God is leading you to do. But sometimes you can only run so far before it all catches up with you. And God has a way of pulling us back and guiding us on the path that He had us to go on in the first place. Sometimes obedience is just better. Keeps us from running down the wrong path. Keeps us from hitting challenges in the road. Sometimes it's just better to do that thing that God has told you to do, because in the end, you'll end up in the place where He was leading you anyway. Good morning, VIP youth. It's Miss Sparkle, and I am definitely excited to be back with you guys for another week. It's been a couple of weeks since the last time, so I'm happy that you're here, that you've joined in, that you've tuned in to get you some weekly inspiration to get going and get connected on what is to come for this week. I'm sure you guys can tell that I am making this video in the car. And you know why I'm making this video in the car? Because I'm hiding, okay? I am trying to hide from my kids. Because usually when they're like, mama, 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 mommy, 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 mama, 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 it means they want me to do something. And this is my escape from trying to do whatever it is they're asking me to do. I am trying to run away from them so I don't have to do what they're asking me to do. But the connection here is, that's what the message is related to today, right? So sometimes there are things that God has called us to do, that God is speaking to us about, and we just don't want to face reality that this is what God is calling us to do. So here's the deal. We're talking about Jonah. Jonah was in a land and God was calling him to go somewhere else, to do some other things, and Jonah did not want to do it. He did not want to be obedient. He did not want to go to the place where God had called him to go. So Jonah decided he was going to run away. He was going to get on a ship with some other sailors and just ride along to wherever they were going. And this did not quite work out how Jonah thought it was going to work out, because Jonah gets on this ship and God is pretty much like, hey, where you think you're going? Okay, I got something for you. So God brings this huge storm. It's rocking the ship. Nobody can hardly stay on board. It's a mess. It's raining. It's storming. They're terrified for their lives. And water's coming on the ship, so they think they're going to go down. So they start throwing stuff overboard. Nothing is working. The storm is still hitting them hard. So they realize, Jonah, you did this. You got on this ship and you caused all of this to happen. Like, who are you? Where are you from? So Jonah finally fesses up, like, okay, yes, me. Like, go ahead and throw me overboard. So they're like, nah, we can't do that. We're going to still try to make sure the ship gets where we're supposed to be going. Jonah's like, I'm telling you, if you throw me overboard, everything will stop. The storm will stop. Everybody will be good. So they do it. They throw him overboard. He goes into the sea. And then I'm sure you've heard the story as a kid. He gets swallowed by a whale. Okay, so this giant fish comes. Jonah's in the belly of the whale. Jonah's got plenty of time to think about his decisions and his better choices he could have made while he's in the belly of this whale. So eventually he understands, man, God, I've been trying to run from you. I've been trying to run from the things you've called me to do. I'm going to go ahead and be obedient. I'm going to go ahead and do what you've asked me to do. Now, you have got to admit that if your parents, aunts, uncles, grandparents, teachers even have asked you to do certain things or asked you to go somewhere and you try to take a detour because you don't really want to do it, like, your parents say, hey, go to the store and get X, Y, and Z, but then you sneak by a friend's house on the way and you hanging out. And then the things don't go right on the way. Like maybe you have a fender bender on the way, or maybe you get a flat tire and you got a call for help and your parents find out you weren't in the place that you were supposed to be in. When we are not obedient, when we don't do what we're called to do, it is an epic fail. And eventually we got to get in line with what we were told to do to begin with. And there's consequences on the other side of that, because then your parents don't trust you to do what you're supposed to do anyway. And it just turns into this series of events like a domino effect. The key here is you have got to do what God has called you to do to begin with. All right. So Jonah's in the belly of the well. He's realizing, man, I should have just been obedient to God. I wouldn't be in this position. I shouldn't have tried to hide from God. I shouldn't have tried to escape what he called me to do. I should have just listened. So God turns things around. He commands the fish to spit Jonah out. And he ends up in the place where he should have gone anyway. So there's that moment when you realize, man, I should have did what I was supposed to do to begin with. Like, I wouldn't even be in this position. And that's the message here. Like, why do you want to put yourself through that? Why would you want to put yourself through torment? Why would you want to put yourself through the hard times, the struggles and challenges, or even other people? Because the people connected to Jonah who were on the ship had to go through the struggles too. So instead of putting yourself and the people around you through hard times or difficult times because of your choices, make the right choice to be obedient to God to begin with. Make the right choice to be obedient to your parents, grandparents, teachers, administrators on campus. Make the right choices to do what you've been assigned, asked, or called to do, okay? Because there's something greater. There's something to being obedient. It shows respect and love for the person who's asking you to do it. Now, yes, I'm sitting in this car, but I promise you I'm going to go back inside and I'm going to be there to do whatever my kids are needing me to do, because there's a reason they're asking you to do it. There's a reason for whatever they're asking you to do. I promise there's greater purpose in it. And if you don't know what your purpose is, or what it is that you need to do, or you feel like you don't know what God is calling you to do, you know it's something but you don't know what it is, reach out and connect with us. There's a number at the bottom of the screen. We will help you and walk you through this journey. We will pray with you just to see what it is that God wants you to do, what you feel like God is speaking to you. We got you on that, I promise. So just text the number, call the number, reach out to us on social media. We have Facebook, we have Instagram. You guys know how to connect because y'all are the kings and queens of connecting, okay? Because y'all know how to do all kind of stuff that we don't necessarily know how to do. But we don't want you to walk this journey alone. We don't want you to have a Jonah experience. We want you to walk in obedience. So know that we're here for you. We're rooting for you. We support you. We got your back. And connect with us if you feel like nobody else does. All right. We are here. I'm going to pray with you. And I'm hoping that you guys have an amazing week to come. Father God in heaven, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for the time that you've allowed us today to have, Lord God. We ask that you would just speak to our hearts, speak to the things that you've called us to do. Make it clear for us, Lord God, so that we can walk in our perfect peace as we follow the direction that you have given us. God, when we want to or are tempted to have those Jonah moments, Lord God, just speak to us and touch our hearts, Lord God, so that we can command our thoughts when they don't line up with yours to do the things that you have asked us to do. Ask that you watch over each and every person that's watching this video today, Lord God. Allow them to have a great and productive week. Allow them to be efficient and effective in everything that they put their hands to, and allow them to walk in purpose and understand their purpose, Lord God. Show them, make it clear, make it plain, so they know what it is that you are giving them to do in their lives to be able to touch and impact others. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, guys, I love you. I hope that the things are going well And don't forget, next Sunday, we're doing face-to-face service, okay? So the details are on the website, www.yourinspirationnow.com. The details are on all our social media platforms. So check out Facebook, check out Instagram if you want the address, if you want to know. But it's going to be at Impact Church next Sunday, September 27th. And it's going to be face-to-face. But remember, bring your mask. Do not come if you're sick or not feeling well. We got hand sanitizer on deck. We're going to be checking temps at the door. So we would be super excited to see you guys. Remember to RSVP. There's been a link that's been going around for you guys to RSVP if you want to come. So again, check out the website, check out social media so you can figure out how to do those things so that we can see you in the place next Sunday. But until I see you guys then, always remember to love, live, and lead. Love you guys. Hope to see you next week. Bye.
I'll go, I'll follow where you lead. Your hand I trust completely.